We're just about to embark on a series of videos in which we're going to go into tremendous detail on just about each one of the different tabs for notifications. But before we do that, let's just build a quick and dirty notification. I want to get one, you know, under our belt so that we can know where we're going with this and just see one in action before we go any further. So what I'm going to do is, first of all, identify what Pi tag I'm going to be monitoring. So I want to have a notification when this tag right here, this is a tag called, as you can see right here, it's listed as MyCDT158. It is an attribute called tag CDT158.value. Boy, that's a long name. We didn't make it very easy there. But anyway, that's the attribute name in an element called monitored tags. If I refresh this, I can see that the current value is 100. What I want to specify here is if this value goes over 250, we want to see a notification. So the first thing to do is to have an element that's got an attribute you'd like to have a notification built off of. Now this attribute happens to point to this Pi tag right here. We'll handle that later on, how to do that update to that tag. So here's a new notification. I'm just going to go into this section here. This is the Navigator panel. In this this little viewer here, I'm going to choose Notification, New Notification, or I could have just done right-click, New Notification. And in the overview, I'm going to give this a name. Here's the notification name. I'm just going to call it My Note 1. It's going to be my first notification. Now, the first thing I need to do is figure out what we're actually going to be monitoring. Now, I looked at it before, but I didn't attach it to this notification. So that's what we do over here in the trigger section. In the trigger, we use this. This is the structure, the tree structure widget that's going to allow me to go through all of my current database and find the element that I'd like to monitor. And in this case, I want to monitor this right here. Now, when I bring that element in, I haven't had to specify the attribute yet. That's going to come later on when we specify, when we come up with the trigger itself, the actual conditions. So what's my condition going to be? Well, this is a simple comparison. I'm going to say when my input attribute, which I can browse to this way, as you can see, it's picked up monitor tags, it's found this. When that is greater than, and we'll put in a value of, say, 250. I'm going to ignore the rest of this for right now. That's my simple notification. Now, I don't even want to put in any subscriptions at this point or go into the detail of content, etc. I just want to save this notification, and then let's start up the notification. And once we start it up, let's see if we can get it to trigger. So I'll go ahead and check this in. Now that I've checked it in, I can start it up. So I'll go ahead and choose Start. And initially, when we start this up, we shouldn't really be seeing anything at this point. If I go into History and look at Active, yeah, I'm not seeing anything at this point. And the reason I'm not is because it is not fired at this point yet. Now I'm going to do a trick that you can do with the Pi System Management Tools. I'm going to use Pi System Management Tools, specifically the Archive Editor in Pi System Management Tools. You'll find that under Start, Programs. This is under the Pi System. We're looking at the Pi System Management Tools here. Anyway, within here, within the Archive Editor, I've actually gone out and specified that I want to retrieve the current values for this tag. And I'm going to change this from 100. Let's push this to 275. And I'll go ahead and save this. So what we should see is, going back over here, we should see that this notification is going to trigger. And as you can see, right on cue, it triggered. Now, a bunch of other things happened that we didn't go into details yet. This is an auto-acknowledge alarm. And that's because if you take a look at how we've, you know, configured this, it was not requiring acknowledgments. That's why it's got this instant acknowledgment. Now, if I were to change this value back to 100, as you might guess, that's going to go ahead and change the notification so that it's no longer in alarm. And we should see that show up as well. So that's a real simple hello world type notification. Now, in the next few videos, we're going to go into more detail about all the different types of triggers, content options, subscriptions, history options, etc.